Hi everyone. Today in this video, let us discuss 11 important side effects of Trazodone. What is this drug Trazodone? Trazodone is one of the antidepressant. This drug can be used for the treatment of major depressive disorder, where Trazodone increases the serotonin levels, thereby it can reduce the symptoms of depression. For the treatment of depression, this drug can be given at initial dose of 150 mg and the dose can be slowly escalated based on the response of this drug. In order to control the symptoms of depression, at least 6 months treatment is required with Trazodone. Since this drug is used for longer period at high dose for treating depression, side effects are also more pronounced with this drug, which should be carefully monitored. Apart from the treatment for depression, Trazodone can also be used for another condition. This drug is indicated for the management of anxiety, where it can be given at a dose of 75 mg. Use of Trazodone produces some sleepiness in the patients. That's why this drug can be used as an off-label purpose as a sleeping aid for the treatment of insomnia. For this purpose, Trazodone can be given at a dose range of 25 to 100 mg. Where it can increase the sleepiness in the patients. And particularly this drug can also reduce the insomnia that is commonly observed in the depressive patient. So these are the various clinical use of Trazodone. In all these conditions, Trazodone should be started at low dose. But in the treatment of depression, the dose may be slowly increased, which may result in significant side effects. So today in this video, we are going to see what are the 11 important side effects of Trazodone. First one is the sedation. Trazodone is one of the antidepressant, so it can act on the CNS, where it can increase the serotonin levels. Thereby, it elevates the mood in the patients, resulting in the antidepressant. But at the same time, it can also increase the sleepiness in the patients. So this drug can produce some sedation, somnolence, some sleepiness and drowsiness in the patients. This is particularly more important when this Trazodone is combined with other drugs or food that again produces CNS depression. When Trazodone is combined with alcohol, the CNS depressant activity is further increased. That's why Trazodone should not be combined with alcohol. Second one is the dizziness. As we have discussed earlier, Trazodone can produce some sedation in the patients. So this drug can increase the drowsiness, which may result in lightheadedness and dizziness in the patient. These effects of Trazodone may impair the daytime activities of the patient. So while using Trazodone, care should be taken while working with machinery or driving the vehicles, as this drug may increase the drowsiness, which may impair the performance in the patients. Apart from these side effects, Trazodone can also increase the confusion, which is more troublesome in the elder people. Third one is effect on eye. Since Trazodone increases the serotonin levels and it can also block adrenergic as well as cholinergic receptors. Because of these effects, Trazodone can increase the pupillary dilatation, which may result in the increased intraocular pressure in few of the patients with narrow angles. So Trazodone can precipitate acute angle closure glaucoma. So in such patients, care should be taken because this drug may increase the risk of further angle closure and raise in the intraocular pressure. But in the normal people, Trazodone can produce some double vision, blurred vision because of anticholinergic side effects as well as pupillary dilatation. So while taking Trazodone, either double vision or blurred vision can be commonly observed in the patients. Fourth one is the prolonged QT interval. Just like many of the antidepressants, Trazodone can also affect the cardiovascular system. This drug, particularly at high dose, it can produce some cardiac arrhythmia. When this drug is prescribed greater than 100 mg, there may be more chance for this drug to produce increased QT interval within the ECG. When the QTC interval is increased within the ECG, it may indicate the development of cardiac arrhythmias. And even it can precipitate one of the conditions, torsades de pointis, which is a fatal cardiac arrhythmia that can be associated with increase in the QT interval. So care should be taken when this Trazodone is given to the patients with pre-existing cardiac arrhythmias. And even with some drugs like itraconazole, clarithromycin, precaution should be taken because these drugs can block the metabolism of trazodone by inhibiting CYP3A4 activity. The cytochrome P450-3A4 enzyme is responsible for metabolism of trazodone. When this enzyme is inhibited by these drugs, trazodone is not significantly metabolized, leading to increased levels within the plasma, which increase the risk of prolonged QT interval. Similarly, if you have the drugs like class 1A antiarrhythmic agents, class 3 antiarrhythmic agents, these drugs can directly increase the QT interval within the ECG. So when they are combined with trazodone, they can precipitate fatal cardiac arrhythmias. So these drugs should be carefully combined with trazodone, and the dosage adjustment should be done in order to avoid prolongation in the QT interval. Fifth one is the orthostatic hypotension. Use of trazodone can affect the blood pressure in the patients. It can reduce the blood pressure, which often changes with change in the position. So trazodone can produce orthostatic hypotension, resulting in syncope and fainting and falling of the patients, which should be carefully monitored. So when trazodone is going to be taken, the patient should take the precaution, particularly when they change the posture, either from lying position to the sitting position or lying position to the standing position, because of a sudden fall in the blood due to vasodilatory effects of trazodone. And when the blood pressure is not improved, it results in falling sensation and syncope in the patients. Sixth one is the peripheral edema. This is another effect of trazodone on the blood vessels. Trazodone can block 5-HT2 receptors, as well as it can block alpha-1 receptors, which are located on the blood vessels. By blocking these receptors, trazodone can increase the vascular permeability, leading to increased vasodilatation and peripheral edema. So with prolonged use of trazodone, peripheral edema can be observed, resulting in the swelling of legs, which is commonly observed at high dose of the trazodone. Seventh one is a dry mouth. This is another effect of trazodone, again commonly observed in most of the patients. This drug can block cholinergic receptors, thereby it can reduce the action of acetylcholine within the CNS. Because of reduced cholinergic action, trazodone can produce a set of anticholinergic side effects. Among them, dry mouth is one of the important side effects that clearly observed in most of the patients. So when this dry mouth is going to be developed with use of trazodone, repeated intake of water or chewing non-sugar candy pills or gums should be used in order to reduce dry mouth and to increase the saliva secretion. Eighth one is a serotonin syndrome. Just like many of the antidepressants, trazodone can also increase serotonin levels. So with raised 5-HT levels within the CNS, it can precipitate one of the condition, serotonin syndrome. This syndrome can be identified by a group of side effects in the patients. So in case of any development of hyperthermia, sudden raise in the body temperature, muscle rigidity, muscle spasm, increased heart rate resulting in tachycardia, confusion, fatigue, tremors. If any of these symptoms are collectively observed in the patients, it may indicate the development of serotonin syndrome. And particularly, this serotonin syndrome may be developed when this trazodone is combined with other drugs which further increase the 5-HT levels. So care should be taken whenever you observe these symptoms because they may indicate serotonin syndrome. Ninth one is the loss of sodium. Trazodone is an antidepressant, but it is also having some inhibitory activity on antidiuretic hormone. Because of inhibition of ADH, it can increase the excretion of sodium, thereby the sodium levels in the serum are going to be reduced, resulting in hyponatremia. This hyponatremia is more significant when sodium levels are fall less than 110 millimoles per liter. This can be observed when this trazodone is combined with drugs like diuretics, which further increase the sodium excretion, thereby they again produce hyponatremia. So in such combinations, we can observe severe headache and unexpected weakness, fatigue, and tremors in the patients. So trazodone should be carefully combined with diuretics to prevent significant hyponatremia. 10th one is a prolonged erection. This effect of trazodone is observed in the men, This drug can produce one of the condition priapism. With use of trazodone, prolonged erection can be observed for greater than 6 hours, resulting in painful erection. So whenever this priapism is observed for greater than 4 hours, care should be taken to prevent any damage to the erectile tissue. 11th one is a suicidal initiation. Just like many of the antidepressants, trazodone can also increase the suicidal thoughts, which is more pronounced in the adolescent as well as young patients. So when this drug is particularly used for treatment of depression, it can reduce the depressive symptoms and it can elevate the mood. But at the same time, because of raised serotonin levels, it can also increase the suicidal thoughts. So when this drug is prescribed in the adolescent and young patients, a close monitoring should be done to check any development of suicidal initiation, which is commonly observed with most of the antidepressants that increase serotonin levels within the CNS. So these are the 11 important side effects of trazodone, which is used as an antidepressant for the treatment of major depressive disorder. This drug can also be used for the treatment of anxiety as well as to treat the insomnia as an off-label purpose. But whatever may be the clinical indication, trazodone can produce various side effects like sedation, somnolence and sleepiness. It can also produce some dizziness and lightheadedness. It can produce some dry mouth because of anticholinergic side effects. Orthostatic hypotension, which may result in syncope and fainting. It can also develop peripheral edema, even increase in the QT interval, resulting in cardiac arrhythmias. In the men, it can produce some prolonged erection, resulting in painful erection. And even it can increase the suicidal initiation in the adolescent and young patients. So all these side effects of trazodone should be kept in mind while using this drug. With proper monitoring of side effects, trazodone can be used as a successful antidepressant to control the depressive symptoms in the patients. So that's all about the side effects of trazodone. Hope you have enjoyed this video. If you like this video, please subscribe to our channel, share this video with your friends, post your comments in the comment box. Thank you for watching this video.